body is ever in any state, constantly. Because the mind is not a constant thing, it's a flux, constant movement. There is nobody who is permanently ever in any state. It's just that the density, the frequency may vary. Somebody may be in the chaotic stage 90% of the time, and there will be another fellow who is not in the chaotic stage 90% of the time. But all of us are always in all states at some point or the other. So we cannot just label anybody. So that will
control our mind.
We can control, but it's not an absolute control. It's not a binary thing, it's a continuous thing. You understand the continuity, but not a quantum jump. Initially, you were chaotic most of the time, and then that chaos reduces, and it is possible that ultimately that chaos gets very close to zero. In the language of mathematics, tending to zero. But it can never be absolutely zero.
So,
you never watch thoughts with the desire to control them. Watching thoughts just means that I know what is going in my mind. It does not mean that I have a great desire to suppress the thought. Because suppressing the thought is another thought. In order to suppress a pre-existing thought, what have you done? You have created another thought. You have added to the chaos. Watching your thoughts just means simply that I know what is going on here. If I am afraid, I know I am afraid. I am not hiding it, I am not suppressing it, I am honest with it. Yes? If I am jealous, petty, disturbed, I can say up front, I know I am disturbed. That's it.
Simple.
There are these things that survive only in ignorance. When you know them, then their potency falls. When you know that I am very, very afraid, then the potency of the fear reduces. Try this. When you are very afraid, tell yourself, Uncle, you are afraid again. Karan, you are again shivering. Karan, you see, this is a habit with you. You are so frequently afraid. Acknowledge it, honestly. And when you will acknowledge it, then the potency of the thought will reduce. Because what's established thing is, that you give energy to your thoughts. When you start acknowledging the thought, then you cut off that energy. That energy, you don't cut it off actually, it gets cut off. And then the thought will lose its potency. After some time, it will slowly just disappear. Getting it? But then, don't try all this as an experiment. You don't approach thoughts with the objective of suppressing them or controlling them. That's no use. Because desire is another thought. These things are not at all complex. They are very simple, provided one looks at them directly. But if one is caged by beliefs, ki mujhe to pehle se hi pata hai, then matters get complicated. Otherwise, they are very simple.